Good morning, students. Now we will move on to the next revision topic, that is cell organelles. Large and complex cell need a lot of chemical activities to support their complicated structure and function. To keep these activities separated from each other, these cells use membrane bound structure. These structure perform specialized function within themselves and are called cell organelles. Now, cell organelles are found within the cell, and there is division of labor within the cell organelles because each one has taken up one particular function. Okay, and what are those functions? Let's try to understand. Endoplasmic reticulum, it is a membrane bound organelle, remember that. It extends from outer nuclear membrane into the cytoplasm. Now, endoplasmic reticulum can also be written as ER, and it occurs in three forms. One is cisternae, vesicles and tubules. Depending upon the nature of its membrane, ER is of two types. One is RER, that is rough endoplasmic reticulum, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum, presence of ribosome. So ribosome is present here, ribosome is absent. Ribosomes are the site of protein synthesis and helps here. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum helps in the manufacture of fat molecules or lipids, and it is formed of cisternae and it is formed of vesicles and tubules. They are found closer to the nucleus. This is found near plasma membrane. So these are the major differences, and the difference between RER and SER is very important. Functions of endoplasmic reticulum. Ribosomes present in all active cell act as a site for protein synthesis, and proteins manufactured here are transported throughout the cell by endoplasmic reticulum. So ribosomes that are present in RER, they act as a site for protein synthesis, and proteins that are manufactured here are also transported throughout the endoplasmic reticulum. Fats and lipids that are synthesized by smooth endoplasmic reticulum help in building of cell membrane. So that process is known as membrane biogenesis. Again, a very important concept. It plays a role in detoxification of poisons and drugs in liver cells of vertebrates. It transports between various regions of the cytoplasm, between cytoplasm and the nucleus. It functions as cytoplasmic framework, so it gives a skeletal structure to it. It provides a surface for some of the biochemical activities of the cell also. It gives mechanical support to the cells. Next, Golgi apparatus. This is the structure of the Golgi apparatus. These are Golgi sacs. It consists of membrane-bound fluid-filled sacs called vesicles and smooth flattened cisternae. So these are the vesicles. These are cisternae, or they are also known as Golgi sacs. Cisternae are stacked parallel to each other. Each of these stacks is called a cistern. Now, Golgi apparatus arises from the membrane of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The material that is synthesized near ER is packed and dispatched to various parts of the cell through Golgi apparatus. Now, what are the functions of Golgi apparatus? It stores, modifies and packs products in vesicles. It's like a packaging material. Now, the material that is being synthesized has to be packed and it has to be supplied to the target organ. So, Golgi body does that packaging. It is involved in the formation of lysosomes. It forms complex sugars from simple sugars in some cases. It is involved in the synthesis of cell wall and plasma membrane. lysosomes. These are a kind of waste disposal system of the cell. Lysosomes are membrane bound sacs that are filled with digestive enzymes, and these enzymes are made by rough endoplasmic reticulum. So the enzymes present within the lysosomes are made by rough endoplasmic reticulum. They are also called the suicidal bags of a cell. When the cell gets damaged, lysosomes may burst and the enzyme can digest their own cell. So the digestive enzymes within the lysosome are so powerful that they can digest their own cell. They are absent in RBCs. Functions of lysosome. They help to keep the cell clean by digesting any foreign material that enters the cell, as well as bone out cellular organelles, hence called scavengers and cellular housekeepers. They remove foreign material by breaking it into pieces through its powerful digestive enzyme. So these enzymes can break down all organic material. So foreign material is broken down into pieces by the enzymes that is present within the lysosome. And during starvation, the lysosome digests stored food contained by autophagy and supply energy to the cell. Next, moving on to mitochondria. Mitochondria is a double membrane structure. It has got an outer membrane, and inner membrane is thrown into folding, and these foldings are known as cristae. They have got the presence of DNA and ribosomes, so it can partially synthesize its own protein, and they are known as a powerhouse of the cell because they can produce ATP. ATP is nothing but adenosine triphosphate. This is also known as energy currency. It provides large surface area for ATP generation. It is a semi-autonomous organelle. It means it can partially synthesize its own protein. This is a very important question, why it is known as semi-autonomous organelle. Even chloroplast is also a semi-autonomous organelle. Next, moving on to functions of mitochondria. It is known as a powerhouse of the cell. ATP molecule breaks down. It generates energy used for metabolic activities of the body. So the ATP molecules which are synthesized, they are broken down and they are used for various metabolic activities of the body, and they are able to make their own protein. Next, we will move on to plastids. Now plastids, we have chloroplast, and it is a type of a chromoplast, leucoplast and chromoplast. So chloroplast we need to study in detail. It is a double membrane structure. It has got the presence of lamella that connects granum, these coin-like structures, and each granum is known as thylakoid. There are starch grains which are presence of DNA and ribosome. It can partially synthesize its protein, and this fluid-like matrix is known as stroma. Next, moving on to leucoplast. It is a white colorless plastid. It stores material. Leucoplasts which store starch are known as amyloplast, oil, elaioplast, protein, granules, alluroplast, chromoplast. It's a colored plastid rich in carotenoid pigments and lipids. They impart color to flowers and fruits. Students, remember, it is mitochondria and chloroplast, which these two are the organelles which has got their own DNA and ribosome, and they can partially synthesize their own protein, because of which they are known as semi-autonomous organelles. and practice the diagrams that is there in the textbook. Now the rest we will again talk about it in the next class.